Okay, good afternoon, class. Welcome to our lesson about anti-differentiation by substitution. Okay. So, nakikita yung presentation ko? Yes? Okay. So, our objectives for this particular topic, anti-differentiation by substitution, you just have to compute the antiderivative of a function using substitution rule. Okay, so anti-differentiation is more challenging than differentiation. To find the derivative of a given function, there are well-established rules that are always applicable to differentiable functions. For anti-differentiation, the antiderivatives given in the previous lesson may not suffice to integrate a given function. A prerequisite is knowledge of the basic anti-differentiation formulas. So some formulas are easily derived, but most of them need to be memorized. Okay, so gaya na sabi ko sa inyo dati, may mga theorems tayo na pinakita ko sa inyo. Dapat talaga familiar kayo, aside from memorize niya siya, familiar kayo on how to use it. Okay? No hard and fast rules can be given as to which method applies in a given situation. So in college, kung magka-college pa kayo, several techniques such as integration by parts, partial fractions, trigonometric substitution will be introduced. This lesson focuses on the most basic technique, antidifferentiation by substitution. So which is the inverse of the chain rule in differentiation. We have, remember, if in our differential calculus, in differentiation, the chain rule, this is the inverse of it. There are occasions when it is possible to perform a difficult piece of integration by first making a substitution. This has the effect of changing the variable and the integrand. The ability to carry out integration by substitution is a skill that develops with practice and experience. But sometimes a sensible substitution may not lead to an integral that can be evaluated. So we must then be prepared to try out alternative substitutions. Suppose we are given an integral of the form, okay, the integral of f g of x times g prime of x dx. We can transform this into another form by changing the independent variable x to u, using the substitution u equals g of x. So in this case, du dx, or derivative of u with respect to x, is equal to g prime x dx, or the derivative of g function dx. Therefore, the integral, if you see my function, the integral of the function g of x, g prime of x dx, is equal to the integral of f of u du. So, when you say substitution, you just have to replace a certain function by u. So medyo hindi nyo pa masyado maintindihan yan. As we go along by giving examples, mas ma-appreciate niya at mas, I hope, you know, maunawaan pa. This change of variable is one of the most important tools available to us. This technique is called integration by substitution. It is often important to guess what will be the useful substitution. Usually, we make a substitution for a function whose derivative also occurs in the integrand. So let's have an example. Okay, evaluate integral of x plus 4 to the fifth power dx. Okay, eyes on the screen, ha? Tingnan nyo mabuti kung paano ko ito gagawin. You have to evaluate the integral of this function to the fifth power dx. Okay, so first, you have to let, ito yung sinasabi natin substitution. This part, a certain function will be substituted by u. So in this example, the x plus 4, we will let this x plus 4 become u. Kaya magiging u to the fifth du. Okay? U, this one, palitan natin ng u. Yan na siya. And then the integral of u to the fifth power, what's the integral of u to the fifth power? Anyone? Our rule, mag-a-add ng 1 sa numerator divided by n plus 1. What's the answer? Anyone? Para lang siyang class integral of x to the fifth. Di ba x to the fifth, pag in-integrate mo siya, x to the fifth magiging x to the 5 plus 1 over 5 plus 1. Kaya ang sagot, x to the 6 over 6 plus c. Don't forget the c. So in this case, anong sagot natin? U ang ginamit natin. Anyone?
U to the 6 power over 6 plus c.
Correct. Okay. U to the 6 power over 6 plus 6. And then to write your final answer, you have to return back from the original term. Ano ba yung u natin? X plus 4, di ba? Because we let x plus 4 become u. So palitan na uli natin yung u ng x plus 4. So the final answer is x plus 4 to the 6 over 6 plus c. Ganun lang kadali. Is that clear? Number 2. Evaluate the integral of x to the 5 plus 2 to the 9th power 5x to the 4th dx. So paano natin siya gagawin? Tayo class ang magle-let ng u. Walang iba kung hindi kayo. Kayo mamimili dyan sino ang u. Okay? Oops. So palagay nyo, sino ang u dyan?
9 po.
No. Di ba sabi ko sa inyo yung u na isa-substitute nyo? O ilelect nyo yung u to be equal to the function. Which function is that? This function, this term, or this term. Ang technique dyan class, yung highest power. Yun yung gagawin yung u. Hindi pwedeng may power 4. E di etong nasa loob nyo may power 5. Highest power, yun yung technique doon. Okay? So u equals x plus 5, x power 5 plus 2. Yun yung u ninyo. Okay? Tingnan natin. Look at this. This is our problem. I let x power 5 plus 2 become u. And then du. Where u equals x power 5 plus 2. Okay? Kaya iyan ang naging u natin, class. Kasi if you find the du, what's the derivative of u? Du of this. What's the du of u? Find the derivative of u. Anyone? Derivative. Anyone? Guess. Any guesses? Pag guess, pwede magkamali. It's all right. Sige na. What's the derivative of u? Du. What's the du of u? Wala. Magtatawag ako, ha? Sige. Magtatawag ako ng mga laging mataas yung nakukuha sa akin. Kasi based on the outputs given, yung mga sinasubmit yung output, yun yung ginigridan ko, eh. Pero kaya hindi ako makapagbigay ng mas mataas sa 94, 95. Hindi ako makapagbigay ng 96 kasi alam kong mahirap to. Imposible may maka 98, 99, 100. Ito pa nga lang, recitation. Wala nagpa-participate. Paano ako magbibigay? Sige nga, subukan nga natin si Reyes. What is du? If u is x5 plus 2, what is du? Hindi ko nababasa kasi. Naka-present kasi ako. Hindi ko nababasa kapag may nagtatype. Wala?
5x to the 4th power po.
How about the 2? What will happen to 2?
Magiging 0 po kasi yung rule number 1 po.
Okay. Very good. Okay, good. 5x to the 4th power, but you missed to say dx. Tandaan mo, may dx tayo. Kapag nagdi-derive tayo, may dx. 5x to the 4th dx. O, di ba ito siya? O, di ba? Nakuha nyo? Kaya nga ang sabi ko sa inyo, ang u ninyo, yung may mataas na power. Kasi ang du, yung susunod. Susunod sa 5, 4. Di ba? 5x to the 4th dx. Ito yung derivative nung u ninyo. Okay? Okay, kaya yan yun. So, u to the n, du. Now, derivative of u to the n is u 10, u to the 10 over 10 plus c. And then, you have to write it back to its original form. Yung u is x5 plus 2. Okay, plus power 10 over 10 plus c. Yan yung final answer natin. Okay, number 3. Example number 3. Evaluate the integral of x over square root of x squared minus 1 dx. So in this case, what is u? Oh, kasi sabi ko lang, ang u, may mataas na power. What is that? Tawag ulit tayo. Ironico, absent. Duerme, absent. Barzaga, nadyan ka? What is u?
Square root of x squared minus 1 po.
Actually, hindi natin sasama yung square root, no? Yung nasa loob lang ng function.
X squared Good. Minus 1.
Correct. Okay. U is x squared minus 1. Therefore, the derivative of u, what is the du? And that 2x, di ba, bababa mo lang to? 2x dx. Okay? 2x dx. Now, may nakita ka bang 2x dx sa problem mo? Wala. Ang nakikita mo sa problem mo ay x dx lang. O anong gagawin mo sa 2? Okay? And then, ibababa ko yung 2 dito. Divide both sides by 2. If I divide this by 2, magiging x dx na lang. Ayun, x dx. Again, if I divide this by 2, magiging x dx na lang. If I divide this by 2, dapat may 2 rin dito. So ito, du over 2. So it implies that x dx equals 1 half du. Okay? Kuha? Next, ito yung problem natin. Equals 1 over u power 1 half. Ito yung original natin, ha? Ito yung u natin. Yung u natin. 1 over u, ginawa ko lang rational exponent. From radical form to rational exponent, u power 1 half, times, ito, saan galing to? 1 over 2 du. Ito, x dx. Kasi meron ka x dx, so ayan, x dx, and x dx is equal to 1 half du. Kinalagay ko lang siya 1 half du. Ito, saan to galing? Ito, yan yung original natin, no? 1 over, may 1 pa rito, di ba? 1 over this one. Inilano ko lang, 1 over u. Kasi nga, u c x squared minus 1. Now, this is a constant. Integral of a constant, you put it outside or bring it outside the integral the integrand sign. So 1 half u to the power negative 1 half. Kasi I put it up para maging negative 1 half. Okay? And then, what is the integral of u negative 1 half? Di ba magpa plus 1 half ka rito over 1 half? Okay, power rule, plus 1 half over 1 half. Sorry, plus 1 half over yung eto. And ito yung lalabas nun. U 1 half over 1 half. This one cancels out. This one cancels out. So, magmatitira ay u to the 1 half, which is anong u? X squared minus 1. U to the 1 half plus c. Okay? And then, baka may pumapasok. So the answer is x squared minus 1 to the 1 half plus c. Hold on for a second. Duerme. Late. Is that clear? Example number 3? Pwede magtanong. Any question?
Sir, yung 1 half po ba galing po sa ano sa may 'di ba po yung sa trigonometry, yung square root po is parang ano equivalent po siya ng 1 half doon po ba galing?
Yes. Ito toto ba itong part na to? U to the 1 half.
Opo.
Oo.
Ah, okay.
Yes, yun. Yung root natin, naka-radical form siya eh. Naka-square root form siya eh. Gawin natin power form. Magiging 1 half yung square root. Okay. Si Tamayo ba nakapasok na?
Hindi mo daw po siya in-admit, sir.
Sige nga, paano ulit si Tamayo? Bago ako bumalik sa presentation ko kasi hindi ko nakikita to. Para hindi siya ma-absent. Tamayo. Si Falcutila ba narito? Jordan, itong bang kaibigan mo na to ay umapasok pa? Nawala na si Jordan. Ironico, narito ba? Wala. Wala. Okay. Sige, go back. Naka-present pa ako, no? Nakikita?
Yes po.
Okay, example number 4. Evaluate, exponential. Integral of e to the 3x dx. What is u? Your u here is 3x. Okay? We let u to be 3x. Class, itong part ng solution na to, talagang kayo magde-decide niyan. Pag nagkamali kayo ng pag-decide ninyo, mali na lang ang solution nyo. Okay? Kaya huwag kayo magkakamaling mag-let. Let u equals 3x. So, derivative of u is 3dx. Kaya lang, class, may nakikita ba kayong 3dx dito? Dx lang, oh. So, anong gagawin natin dun sa 3? You have to, hence, dx is equal to du over 3. Para makuha nyo yung dx equals du over 3. Saan galing itong dx is equal to du over 3 from here, oh? Divide by 3, divide by 3. Dx now equals du over 3. Yun yung sa substitute. May pumapasok ba? Dali. Ayun, Ronico. Ronico, late! Bakit late? Number 4. Ayan. So, naintindihan na ito. Narito na ako, di ba? So, dx is equal to du over 3. Now, our problem is integral of e to the 3x dx. So, change natin yung 3x. Sabi rito, u equals 3x. E to the u. Pinalitan ko itong 3x ng u. Tapos, yung dx dito, itong dx na to, pinalitan ko nito from this one. Okay? Sunod-sunod yan. Pag nagkamali ka ng solve o paglalagay ng mga yan, mali na. Okay? So, du over 3. Kasi nga, dx equals du over 3. Next. So, since we have what? Automatic, this is 1 over 3. That's constant. 1 over 3, napupunta sa labas, 1 over 3, integral of e to the u du. What's the integral of e to the u du? Theorem yan. It's a theorem. Integral of e to the u du I? E to the u. E to the u. E to the u lang din. Okay? Plus c. Again, itong part na to, the integral of e to the u du is simply e to the u plus c. Now, may u ka pa. Palitan natin yan. To write the final answer, change u to 3x. Kaya ang final answer, 1 over 3 e to the 3x plus c. And that's our final answer. Number 5. Any question? Nala? Okay, number 5. Evaluate integral of cosine 4x plus 3 dx. What is our u? Our u is, basically, yung 4x plus 3. If u is 4x plus 3, what's the derivative of u? What's the derivative of this? So, du equals 4dx. May nakita bang 4dx dito? Wala, dx lang. So, may gagawin ka dito. Okay? May gagawin ka dito para magkaroon ng 4. Dx, divide both sides by 4. Divide by 4, kaya cancel yung 4 dito. Dx equals du over 4 or 1/4 du. Okay? So the problem equals integral of cosine u, dahil pinalitan ko yung 4x plus 3 ng u, times this is dx. Ayun o, dx yan eh. What is dx? 1/4 du. Okay? Now, this is constant. Okay? Put it outside the integrand sign. integral sine, cosine u du. What's the integral of cosine u du? Integral of cosine u is sine u plus c. Okay, tapos palitan na natin yung u ng 4x plus 3 plus c. That's, this is our final answer. Question. Walang question. Number 6. Balikan nyo na lang, recorded naman eh. Evaluate the integral of sine x cosine x dx. What is our u? Sir, pwede bang sine x yung u? Yes. Yung u ay sine x. Yes, pwede. Yung cosine x u, pwede yun. Okay. Dalawang approach dito. Kasi bakit? What is the derivative of sine x? Cosine x. What's the derivative of sine x? Cosine x dx. What's the derivative of cosine x? Negative sine x dx. Makikita mo yung sagot doon dito sa problem. Okay? So therefore, u is sine x. This is our first possible answer. Okay? Kasi the other possible answer, when you let u to be cosine x, that's another possible answer. So for this time, unahin muna natin yung u is equal to sine x. Kasi ang derivative ng du ay cosine x dx. May makikita ka bang cosine x dx sa problem? Yes, ayun o. Yan yung du mo. Okay? Kasi ang u mo ay sine x, ang du mo cosine x dx. So this is our problem. Equals integral of u. What is u again? Our u is sine x. Our du is cosine x dx. Now, what's the integral of u? Oh, power rule, u2 over 2 plus c. Kaya yan may 1 kasi nga may iba pang possible answer. Okay? So, integral of u du is u2 over 2 plus c. Actually, kaya din ang c na lang dyan. Okay, plus c. Then, yung u natin, ay balik natin sa dati. Sine x power 2. Okay, over 2 plus c. Okay? Any question? Wala? Sir, bakit yung square dito na dyan, hindi dito? Pag nilagay mo to dito, mali. Pag narito, tama. Pwede rin, since ang u natin ay sine x, pwedeng ilagay natin ang open parenthesis sine x, close parenthesis square. Mas safe yun. Okay, papalitan mo lang yun ng sine x. Open parenthesis, squared. Pwede yun. Ito, pwede rin to. Pero never sine x power 2. Mali yun. Over 2 plus c. That's the answer. Number 7. Evaluate the integral of e to the sine x, cosine x dx. What is u? Tawag tayo. Tingnan ko nga yung mga deserving kong binigyan ng mga grade. Poblete? What is u?
Po. Sine x po.
Okay, sine x. Correct. Sine x is your u. Now, if you let your u to be sine x, okay, therefore, ang du mo equals, what's the derivative of u? Derivative of sine x, cosine x dx. Makikita mo ba itong cosine x dx sa problem? Ayun, no? Okay. Dapat kasi makikita mo sa problem. Pag di mo siya nakita sa problem, yung example number 3, 4, ginagawa natin ng paraan, di ba? Dinidivide natin, nagdi-divide tayo. Okay? So since nasa problem na siya, tingnan natin. This is our problem. Equals integral of e to the u. U is sine x, right? And then du. Pinalitan ko ng du, c cos x dx. Cos x dx is du. You know, du is cos x dx. Now, what's the integral of e to the u? The integral of e to the u is simply e to the u plus c. Yan yung sagot. The integral of this problem is e to the u plus c. And then, sulat natin yung original form ng u, sine x. So the answer here is e to the sine x plus c. That ends our first part. The summary table, or the table of integrals, yan yung mga dati nating ano, di ba? Integral of sine x, negative cosine x, integral of cosine x, ano pa ba? O yan o, integral of e to the x dx, e to the x plus c. Summary lang to ng integral. Okay? For your activity 1, evaluate the following integrals. Ang dami naman. No, answer only 10 problems of your choice. So pili lang kayo dyan ng 10. Siyempre, yung 10 type ninyo, yung palagay nyong madali sa inyo. Okay? 10 lang. Clear? Next. So our last topic is about illustration of the fundamental theorem of calculus. Okay? So here, the objective is to illustrate the fundamental theorem of calculus, or FTOC, and compute the definite integral of function using the fundamental theorem of calculus. Let's start. FTOC, or the fundamental theorem of calculus, states that let f be a continuous function on a, b, and let f be an antiderivative of the function, that is, f prime x is equal to f of x. Then, the integral of the function dx, you have the limits from a to b, huh? A to b equals f b minus f a. Sabihin, derivative, nakuha nyo na yung antiderivative ng problem. Na-integrate nyo na siya. Then, substitute nyo yung b at saka yung a. Okay? So, vertical bar notation. Let's have, ano nga ba yung may a and b na yan? Kasi nakakalito, ano, a and b. So, pag nakakita tayo nyo, you have function a to b, fb minus fa. Example, this is your function, 1 plus x minus x squared. Yung b muna, kasi yan ang nauna, b. So, what's the value for b? 2. Okay? So, lahat ng x nyo, gagawin yung 2. So, ilang x meron kayo? Madami ba kayong x? Dapat isa lang, ha? But in this case, dalawa daw unahin nating x. So, meron kang dalawang x dyan. 1 plus x is 2 minus x is 2 again, power 2. Minus yan na, huwag papalitan. Minus, this time, yung a naman, 1. Substitute 1 to your x's. This is our x, this is our x. So, evaluate this, that's negative 1. Evaluate this, that is 1. Negative 1 minus 1 equals to negative 2. Likewise, kung ganito yung problem natin, sine x, so palitan lang natin si x ng, o yung b muna, yung sine 90 degree. Pi over 2 is 90 degree. Okay? Sine 90 degree minus sine 45 degree equals what? Ito yung una, 1 minus square root of 2 over 2, etc., etc. So using the above notation, the FTOC now states, if f is an antiderivative of f, then, so this is our formula. Okay? Let's have an example. Here, the problem is this. This is our problem. The integral of x squared dx from 0 to 1. This is our problem. The first thing to do is to integrate. Find the antiderivative of x squared dx. What's the integral of x squared dx? Anyone? Nadyan na yung sagot, oh. Bailon. Hindi pa masagot. Jovellanos. Nasayaw. What is
x squared?
What's the integral of x squared dx?
X squared po ata.
Again?
X squared po.
Yun yung sagot mo?
Opo.
Ako sir, try ko po.
Sige.
X cubed over 3.
Uy, sabi ko nga, nadun na natin yung sagot eh, ano? Sabi ko natin yung sagot, oh.
Yun po yung diba? Fx. Tapos, yun po yung fx. Tapos po, isasabi.
Yeah, ito yung sagot. Ito yung antiderivative. Okay, the antiderivative of the problem. di ba, plus 1 over 2 plus 1, yan yung sagot. Now, i-evaluate pa natin from 0 to 1. 0 to 1, o ano ba yung ano natin? 0, never mind this one, nalilito kayo dito. Simulan na natin dito. What is x? 1 to the third power. Right? What's 1 to the third power? 1 over 3. Minus, eto uli. Pero this time, 0 na to. 0 to the third power is 0 over 3. 0 over 3 is 0. Kaya 1 third minus 0 is 1 over 3. So this is a definite integral, ha? Plus. Definite integral, kaya walang plus c. Yung plus c,
yung 1 to 0 to 1, sir?
Again, again?
Yung
yes, 0 to 1.
This
is definite. Ang pinag-uusapan na, this is a definite integral, ha? Kaya nawawala na yung plus c. Kasi baka mamaya sabihin nyo, sir, x, ang integral po nito ay x power 3 over 3 plus c. You don't have to write plus c here. Okay. Basta nakakita nyo itong problem, it's a definite integral, kaya hindi nilalagay yung plus c. So ang sagot dito, x cube over 3, and then from zero, evaluate from 0 to 1. Okay, unahin mo yung 1, susunod yung 0, kaya 1 over 3 minus 0 equals 1 over 3. Clear? Next. Okay, find the exact values of the following definite integrals. Okay, using FTOC. Okay, this one, from 1 to 2. Ayan. The problem is, integral of 3 to the x, integral of 3 dx from 1 to 2. What's integral of 3 dx?
3x.
Okay, so 3x from 1 to 2. So, unahin ko muna si, susulat ko si 3x, pero ang x ay 2. Okay, so ano yung sagot doon? 6. Minus, 3 times x, x this time is 1. Lalabas?
3.
6 minus 3. 3. Okay. Substitute lang ito. Una dito. Sunod ito. I-minus mo yon. So 6 minus 3 is 3. Iba lang yung approach dito. Pasan?
Sir, 3 times 3 tapos parang i-divide mo siya sa 3. So 3.
Walang 3 times 3 ha? 3 times 2.
Ah, mga pala. Ah, okay sir.
3 times 2. Minus 3 times 1. Okay? Kaya 3. Okay? How about, try nga natin yung number 3. This is our problem. What's the derivative of this function? The derivative of this function is 3x squared over 2. Tama? Plus, derivative. Integral of 1. X. Di ba? Okay, now. Naintindihan ba? The integral of this function is this. And then evaluate from 1 to 3. So 3 yung 3 muna. Substitute natin dito at saka dito. Okay? Kaya lumalabas, 3 squared is 9 times 3, 27. O ito pa, gawin natin 3. Ayun, 3. So 27 over 2 plus 3. Next, yung 1 naman. 1 squared times 3 over 2 is 3 over 2. Plus, yun, 1. Now, when you evaluate this using calculator or manually, the answer is 14. Okay? Sa mga advanced, yung number 4, pwede nyo itry yan. Subukan nyo lang. Okay? And last one, this one, evaluate the following integrals using FTOC. Okay, number 1, letter A. What's the integral of this? 2x minus 2. Anyone?
2x.
Sulia. What's the answer? When you integrate 2x minus 2.
0 po.
Oho, wrong. Next. Let's try Dulay. Call a friend na pizza. Wala. Sino maglalakas loob magbigay ng sagot? Integral of 2x minus 2. Pascual.
Yung 2x minus 2 po, sir.
Yes, what's the integral of 2x minus 2?
2x.
Sino nakakalam ng sagot? Barkas!
Squared over 2 minus 2x.
Again?
Squared over 2 minus 2x.
Squared? Ano yung squared? Di ko magets.
Ay, x squared over 2 minus 2x.
Naku. X squared over 2 minus 2x. May konting mali lang.
X squared minus 2 po.
Yun! Bakit may over 2 pa? Makakancel yun, di ba? Makakancel yung 2. X squared na lang yan. Good. Sino yun?
Pavilianos po.
Okay. Eto yun, no? Di ba? Di ba 1 plus 1, that is 2 over 2. Ayun, no? 2 over 2. Makakancel na to. Kaya matitira x squared minus 2x. So yung x squared minus 2x ang i-evaluate mo from 0 to 5. Okay, so never mind this one, maka-cancel na to. Okay, x squared. Unahin natin yung 5, ha? X squared, 25. 2 times 5, 10. Okay, minus, yung pangalawa naman, yung 0 naman. 0 squared, 0. 2 times 0. 0. So, wala na to. Ito na lang sagutan natin. 25 minus 10, 15. Okay? So, the final answer is 15. Class, nalimutan ko. Kaya ang mga sagot natin dito ay definite. Kaya tinawag na definite integral. We are looking for the area of a certain region. Okay? Area, kunyari, area of pag nag-drawing ka ng isang graph, merong shaded area, yung area na yun ang sinosolve natin. Kaya kung mapapansin nyo, definite yung answer natin. Number. Walang variable. Okay? Letter B. Can you tell me what is the integral of sine x dx? Before we evaluate from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, can you tell me what's the integral of sine x dx? Nasa table to.
Cos x po.
Cos x. Talaga? Tingnan natin. Ay, may mali. Negative cos x. Okay? Kasi ang derivative of sine x, cosine x. Pero kapag integral of that is negative cos x. Okay? So, mali ka lang. Nalimutan mo lang yung negative. Importante pa man din ang sine. So, the answer is negative cos x. Evaluate natin from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Okay? Cosine pi over 2. What's the answer? Zero na agad yun ah. Di ba? Same with negative pi over 2, 0 na rin agad yun. Can you double check using your calculator? 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. Okay? Any question? So the answer there is 0. Madali ba? Nakakahilo, di ba? Oh, now, for your final activity, answer only 5 problems of your choice. Yung mga naka-asterisk dyan, for advanced learners, kung feeling nyo magaling na magaling kayo, then do it. Pasiklaban nyo ako para masaya. So, 5 lang. Okay? 5 problems of your choice. Any question? Any question? Wait lang ha.
Sir, pabalik.
Pabalik? Okay, sige. Balik natin.
Yung page 22.
Yan? This one? Which part?
Hindi sir, yung ano po, yung sasagutan.
Ay, sagutan. Yan. Opos ko naman eh, kaya lang pina-process pa ni YouTube kaya medyo tumatagal. Okay? Okay, if there's no question, stop ko na yung recording. Stop recording. Thank you for your cooperation. Thanks for listening.